from a $150 tryout to a $20 million contract. This is the story of Jonathon Simmons. Now, before I get started with the story, I want to give a massive shout out to SeatGeek. Thank you for sponsoring this video. Now, you've obviously heard of SeatGeek before, but if you haven't, SeatGeek is an app that aggregates tickets from all over the web to make buying tickets easy. They put a 1 to 100 score on each ticket to let you know if you're getting a good deal or a bad deal. The green is a good deal, the red is a bad deal. And the awesome part about it is when you click on a deal that you enjoy, you can actually click on that deal and look at the view from where you'll be sitting. And so thanks to SeatGeek, you can enter the promo code NickSmith all in capitals for $20 back on your first order. So definitely download the app by clicking the link below and let's get on with the video. The Jonathon Simmons story has been known by a lot of people around the NBA. I mean, it's known as the greatest story in basketball. Obviously, up for debate, there's so many incredible stories, but this story right here, I'm sure most of you guys know about it. Now, I thought it was the perfect opportunity to make this story considering that Jonathon Simmons has recently signed a contract with the Orlando Magic. And, you know, I wasn't going to make a video on the Jonathon Simmons story because I thought that many of you guys have seen the story before or heard it before, but when I looked at other videos, I saw that they were missing a lot of information in their videos, so I thought I might as well make my own video. If you've seen it, I apologize, but I will talk about the Jonathon Simmons effect to the Orlando Magic because the guy signed with them, $20 million, 3-year contract. The story is amazing, but in Orlando, he'll have opportunities and he'll join a team that needs a boost. So for Orlando, they picked up a great guy who they really don't know what his potential will be in the NBA. And for Jonathon Simmons, well, this just adds another side to Jonathon Simmons' story because, well, if you haven't heard the story, you will be amazed because his story is incredible. Let's just get into it. We start the story here. Jonathon Simmons is a 5'7" guard who was considering dropping out of high school. He was, well, a 40% average, didn't reach senior year, and he was known as a guy that was just going to drop out of school. But by his junior year in basketball, Simmons had shot up to 6'3". He got recruits from, you know, CMU, Texas, A&M, Marquette. 6'3" and athletic, he looked pretty good. That's why all these colleges want him. Unfortunately, though, he just wasn't that good considering academic struggles forced him to take the junior college route, which pretty much messed him up. He played his freshman season at Paris Junior College, averaging 12 points, and, I mean, he did make all-conference honors, but he wasn't amazing. 12 points, and, I mean, 12 points is good, but it's not crazy. It's not really NBA level for a guy that wants to do well. He then transferred to Midland for his sophomore season and upped his scoring to 13.3 points per game. The thing is though, when he did that, he became more of a defensive player, which he really is known now for in the NBA. He signed a national letter of intent to play at the University of Houston in November 2010, and then he sat out the 2010-11 season in compliance with the NCAA's transfer regulation. Then, afterwards, obviously, he went to the University of Houston, and he did pretty well. He declared for the 2012 NBA draft and signed with an agent, but then he went undrafted. Which, I guess you could kind of see how it happened. I mean, he didn't dominate. He averaged 14.7 points per game, which, I mean, like I said, it's good, but it's not really that good for NBA players I'm talking about. The thing was, though, he had defense. He had heart. He had determination. And that's what really got him here. Because on January 2013, he was drafted by the American Basketball League Sugarland Legends, a D-League team, which, well, they weren't that good, but he then went to average 36.5 points in 16 games. He tried out for the Spurs D-League team, which one of the best choices he's ever made in his life. Just to clear it up as well, the team has since been renamed the Austin Spurs, but to get into that team, Jonathon Simmons had to pay a $150 registration fee. Now, Jonathon Simmons had a family. He also didn't have much money, he failed school, and didn't really have much of a future. So $150 for him was quite a bit of money, and this is why the story is so intriguing. Simmons stood out though, earning an invitation to a training camp with the San Antonio Spurs, making it onto the team's opening night roster. He averaged 9.8 points per game in 23 minutes during his first NBA D-League season. Then, in the 2014-15 season, he had a breakout season for the Spurs. Simmons said that during his time in Austin, he considered giving up on his basketball career, moving back home, working a 9-to-5 job to take care of his four daughters. He said, "I was just gonna wing it." He then pushed on. During his second season, he vaulted his way to an NBA Raider. The San Antonio Spurs ended up taking him off. They saw what he could do. He averaged 15.2 points per game, 4 rebounds, 3.7 assists, and helped make them to the Western Conference Finals. He showed what he could do. He then leads the Spurs Summer League team to an NBA championship. Simmons was on a bus in Orlando, having just completed his third and final game, when he received a call from his agent. His agent said, "John, you are now an NBA player." He said, "Okay. The Spurs just gave you a 2-year deal." And then he's like, I'm like, "What?" That's all I could say. I was like, "Hold on, what?" Now then, he became a high-flying 6'6" guard and turned into a real nice player under Greg Popovich. So that's the Jonathon Simmons story. I mean, you can continue it by saying he went and won the MVP in the Summer League. He went to crack the Spurs rotation. In his first ever game in the NBA, he went to guard Steph Curry. This year, at the start of the year, the man went crazy. He played real well against the Golden State Warriors. First game of the year, if you all remember that, I hope you all remember that, you know, first game with Kevin Durant playing in Golden State. Jonathon Simmons, he stole the show. The guy dominated. So let me know down below. I mean, the reason I made this video, though, is because of this. The man Jonathon Simmons, you want to talk about a story, this is a story. This is one of the greatest stories. I mean, he was a 5'7" guard, dropping out of high school. Then now, he paid $150 just to enter a Spurs D-League team, and now Jonathon Simmons just signed an NBA contract with the Orlando Magic on a 3-year deal. Now, the Magic will give him that opportunity that the Spurs didn't really give him. Because you want to talk about minutes, well, let's just talk about the minutes right now, because Orlando, they don't have the best team at the moment. So for Orlando, getting a guy like Simmons, well, they can play him at the small forward position, the shooting guard position, and he can just play as much as he wants. But just going from $150 to a $20 million deal, that just shows you a crazy story in itself. He's a perfect 3-and-D guy for the Orlando Magic, and I mean, you want to talk about defense and heart and toughness, Simmons was very successful. And that's only because of the determination he's had in the NBA. So it'll be interesting to see if he can play that way in Orlando. But let me know down below what you think about the story. I mean, he paid $150 just for a tryout for the San Antonio Spurs D-League team after not getting drafted. And then in Austin, he did it. He made it. $150 just turned into $20 million. And that's a crazy story right there. So let me know down below what you think about this story. If you guys enjoyed it, definitely hit that subscribe button. If you guys want to aim for 3,000 likes, that would be awesome. But yeah, like I said, definitely hit the subscribe button if you are new around here. I make a whole bunch of NBA stories as well as just NBA content on this channel every 2 to 3 days. So definitely hit that subscribe button and I'll catch you guys in my next video. I'm out. Peace.